Showers and thunderstorms continue to put down a lot of rain across central and eastern Kentucky. The very latest on the flood threat coming up.
It was a close call for a Lexington homeowner after a crash earlier this morning. And police in Bardstown are hoping a fundraiser not only serves as a memorial to one of their fallen, but helps generate tips in the case.
Tracking, alerting, protecting. WKYT News starts now with First Alert Weather.
Good afternoon to you. Amber Philpott and Jennifer Palumbo reporting. Rain continues across the Bluegrass and it will stick around through the rest of our evening.
A WKYT First Alert Severe Weather Day continues. We begin with Chief Meteorologist Chris Bailey to see what's on the First Alert Defender. Chris, a lot of rain on it.
Oh, absolutely. And that has been the trend for what? Oh, the past several months. Certainly this week. Certainly again today. You want to talk about just a soggy, nasty day out there. This is basically it. And we're seeing those rounds of showers and thunderstorms that continue into parts of the area with low pressure that is out across western Kentucky. Heaviest rains right now in Defender showing up across southeastern Kentucky. Hindman, Hazard, over into Manchester, Clay County. A few heavier raindrops here into parts of Bell County where you had flooding around this time yesterday. That extends northward into parts of the Owsley County area, Lee County around Beattyville, into Frenchburg, Menifee County, Owingsville, Mount Sterling, where you had some big time flooding earlier this week. Rain's a little more scattered in nature across the downtown Lexington area and most of central Kentucky. That view that is out there, we go into a wet weather period, we dry it up for a few minutes, and then another shower comes on into town. You can see another little raindrop heading across the Hamburg Pavilion area. More showers into parts of west central Kentucky and across that Interstate 65 corridor. That's where the heavier rains are currently falling. Still that flash flood watch out for central and eastern Kentucky. And as we go through the next several hours, ladies, potential is there for a few hot spots of rain that can cause some at least local high water issues. As always, we'll be here to track it through the evening.
Chris, thank you. A frightening scene this morning in Lexington. A crash ended with a car just feet from a woman's home. It happened at the intersection of Jefferson and Short Streets.
As WKYT's Rebecca Smith shows us, those who live in the area say they've seen this happen before. It's our top story at 4:30.
Getting ready for work was no drama-free task for Donna Wheeler this morning. This BMW, or what's left of it, landed right in the front yard after it was involved in a T-bone accident with another vehicle at the intersection. The fire department performed an extrication. The patient was transferred to UK Hospital. Wheeler says it's not the first time something like this has happened. She's got the sound of crashes past memorized.
Well, normally when there's an accident, it sounds like two trash cans being tossed, good old-fashioned galvanized steel trash cans.
At this intersection of Jefferson and Short, there used to be a stop sign. Now it's a traffic light. The homeowner, Donna, says that she hopes that maybe at some point in the future this intersection can be cleared up and made to be not quite as dangerous.
People just don't pay attention to that light. They're looking at the light down the road at Main Street and they're thinking, oh, I've got to get that light. And they whiz through this intersection.
It's a fairly dangerous intersection, so people should pay attention when they're here.
Firefighters have some advice so you don't end up like this.
Just increase your following distances and be more cautious.
In Lexington, Rebecca Smith, WKYT.
Now, part of Short Street near the bar and restaurant corridor will actually undergo a bit of a makeover before the Breeders' Cup this fall. It will be made more pedestrian friendly with sidewalks extended by 8 feet in some areas. 2 years after Bardstown officer Jason Ellis was killed in the line of duty, police still haven't made an arrest.
In the 26 months since his murder, there have been dozens of events and fundraisers for his family and the community he served. As Lauren Adams reports, organizers hope the latest event scheduled for this weekend will not only keep Jason Ellis's memory alive, but generate some much-needed tips in this story that's new at 4:30.
Here is five or six of our classmates that came all the way from Ashland, Kentucky.
But for the Police Academy's class of 2006, May 30th, 2013 was the most bittersweet of reunions. It's when Bardstown officer Jason Ellis, gunned down 5 days before on his way home, had been laid to rest.
You see anywhere from 50 to 150 cars following each other. Gives you goosebumps.
Chief Deputy Raymond Pinaroa with the Nelson County Sheriff's Office was in that funeral procession and in Ellis's Police Academy class. Now, some 26 months later, that hurt has been replaced by frustration.
It's 2 years plus, and we're like, why not how it usually works? why not that piece of the puzzle that we need to get something going towards the right direction?
We're still looking for answers and haven't got any.
It's why for the third year, Matt Schrader with Joe Hill's Victory is organizing a poker run in Ellis's honor. The first year netted some $30,000 for Ellis's widow and children and drew over 300 bikers.
This is just one parking lot, and there were several. I mean, there was people everywhere for this.
He hopes this year's event attracts not just bikers, but tips on a case that's grown cold.
Everybody wants to see someone brought to justice for something as horrible as this.
Chief Deputy Raymond Pinaroa, meanwhile, says events like this will continue. But more importantly, so too will the search for a killer.
The goal is never forget and until justice is served. And that's the goal, never forget.
This year, proceeds from the poker run will go to the Fraternal Order of Police, Old Kentucky Home Lodge 43, where Ellis was a member.
The lodge recently set up a scholarship in Ellis's name and said money raised will go toward that and community outreach programs as well. Registration starts Saturday at 9:30 at Joe Hill's Victory on South Salem Drive in Bardstown. Police say a man is dead after a confrontation with officers outside a Louisville convenience store. Police say five officers went to a food mart on a break. That's according to police. The man said something to the officers outside and then pulled a knife. They say the man then charged at them with the knife and two officers fired several shots. He was pronounced dead at the scene. Police plan to release surveillance video of that incident today.
Many school administrators fear Kentucky's new juvenile discipline policies will lead to more disruption in the classrooms. Under Senate Bill 200, students caught stealing or trafficking drugs could now go to therapy or counseling instead of a detention center. Lawmakers hope that many students who would have been jailed or suspended for nonviolent, low-level felonies and misdemeanors will get to continue their education in their regular classroom. Those who are worried about the new law say it means more students with behavioral issues could be in classrooms with students who want to learn.
It's just an approach to manage low-level offenses, knowing that there's underlying causes that are creating those low-level offenses. And it's really an approach to just help kids.
WKYT investigative reporter Mark Barber has been talking to people on both sides of the controversial new law. Tonight at 6, he's digging to find out how the new discipline policies will affect the safety of students.
Rain, rain, go away. Unfortunately, it is out there again across central and eastern Kentucky this evening. We'll track the potential for local flooding, but I'll come back in a moment.